A gas refinery under construction in the west of Ireland has become the focus of an environmental battle amid claims that aluminium from the works is getting into the tap water. The Irish Republic's rapid growth since the 90s has made the Dublin government keen to develop new fuel supplies, such as the Corrib offshore gas field discovered a decade ago. But the construction by Shell of a gas refinery at nearby Erris has run into strong opposition in the area. And More4 News has discovered evidence to support local fears, as Grish Juniger reports from County Mayo.
I am thought of calling it the Benji Straw Drill.
Shell's ethical advertising has become famous. The company's image, urbane, sophisticated, and responsible.
Wells means less disruption and less waste.
Yeah! But these protesters have a different view of Shell. It's the west of Ireland, County Mayo, and Shell, along with two other companies, is building a multi-million pounds gas refinery. It's not been welcomed by all of those that live in its shadow, but Ireland imports almost all of its gas. Like Britain, it's vulnerable to any disruption of supplies, so Shell's investment has been embraced by Irish politicians across the spectrum.
Incidents like the one behind me are common. For coming up to 2 years, every morning at about 6:30, locals, ranging from farmers and fishermen to teachers, gather here to picket the site.
This year, the campaigners spotted silvery shards in the discharge water. They claim it's aluminium, a neurotoxin linked to crippling conditions such as Alzheimer's. Shell's wastewater ends up at Carrowmore Lake, a reservoir that supplies 10,000 homes. The campaigners say the aluminium from the Shell site poisons this drinking water. The critics say that Mayo County Council, the body charged with ensuring the safety of the water, has not been tough enough on Shell. Shell has a contract with the council which lays down minimum standards. Mayo County Council has told More4 News that it does enforce the contract and that the contaminated water enters from only one of many tributaries that flow into the lake. They go on to say that there is naturally occurring aluminium in all of them and that there is no danger to public health. More4 News has seen evidence that aluminium is leaving the Shell site over and above the levels agreed with the council. The source of the aluminium? The very ground that the site is built on.
500,000 tons of this stuff, wet Atlantic peat, has been dug up to build this site. But round here it serves an important natural function. It keeps trapped deep underground a soil that contains high concentrations of aluminium.
In its planning agreement with the council, Shell must ensure that water leaving its site has an aluminium content of no more than 200 micrograms per litre, a very high standard. Concerned that this was being flouted, a local blacksmith, John Moynihan, began conducting his own tests. He found that the aluminium content was consistently above the agreed limit. Then, when conducting a test on March the 7th, Moynihan found levels so great that his kit could not measure them, suggesting that they were somewhere above 3,500 micrograms per litre. That's 17 times the maximum limit agreed between Shell and the council.
Since we started really digging and keeping an eye on the monitoring, which is available to the public, we've asked basic questions. There's a limit set. Why is it over the limit? Why was the limit set at this level, and so on? They've always been in breach of the figures and limit set on them.
We checked the official statistics. They are conducted by Shell, but published by the council. We discovered that a worrying new phrase has been introduced. It's called above the level of detection. This phrase appears twice in just 2 weeks in early March. It means there's so much aluminium in the discharge water that Shell's own machinery is incapable of measuring it, making it somewhere above 2,000 micrograms per litre, over 10 times the limit agreed with the council. When we contacted Shell about these breaches, they referred us on to Mayo County Council. The council said they had detected the exceedances and had instructed Shell to carry out mitigation works. They continued that there had been a significant improvement in the quality of the water leaving the site since mid-March. But an analysis of the data shows there is still too much aluminium in the water. Between March and May, it consistently breached the agreed levels and went above the level of detection three times. We put this to the council, who argued that aluminium content was down on average from the previous quarter. Campaigners argue that Ireland's political establishment is more interested in attracting energy companies than enforcing safety measures. But energy analysts say that with diminishing fuel supplies, local authorities across the Western world will face increasingly tough decisions.
They're pitted between the specific interest and the general interest. I mean, they have a wider responsibility in addressing wider group of interests, including ultimately the public interest, as well as dealing with their immediate constituents. All these interests are quite legitimate and equally valid, but it's their job to actually sort out and reconcile a solution.
Shell's problems in Ireland wouldn't matter if tap water had not been affected. Bad news is, the available data says it has been. The World Health Organization rules that there should be no more than 200 micrograms of aluminium per litre of drinking water. But on January the 23rd, it reached 1,714 micrograms. That's 8 times the level deemed to be safe. And the next day, it was down to 406. That's still twice the limit. The council explained that these high points were due to a short-lived incident at the water treatment plant. They insist that the construction of the refinery is having no significant impact on water quality. Further tap water quality test results should be available on the Mayo County Council website, but the link appears to have been disabled. And despite repeated requests, we've been unable to obtain any more test results. Promising to process 10 million cubic metres of gas a day, the refinery will bring immense benefit to Ireland's voraciously growing national economy. Nearly 300 locals are employed on the construction site already, and Shell says it also pumps £1 million a week into the local economy. So in a world of diminishing resources, the question faced by Ireland will become increasingly typical. Can the public trust the political will to enforce safety measures on much-needed fuel companies? Grish Janeja, More4 News, County Mayo, the Republic of Ireland.